this is a lot better back in the great outdoors. I love it. All right, let's turn our attention back to the Challenger conspiracy. So we have people, mostly flat earthers, claiming the crew is alive and well, and apparently they've even kept their same names and are even working very public jobs. Now this sounds completely preposterous considering we saw the Challenger blow up while en route to space. And if you don't know about it, basically the shuttle took off from Florida on a very cold day in January, and about 73 seconds into the mission, a booster engine failed and caused the Challenger to break apart. And I remember that day very well because I was in eighth grade and I was coming home from school and we saw it all over the TV. It was being played over and over again. So fast forward 30 years and this idea begins to take shape that the crew is still alive. And of course this presumes the crew never actually boarded the Challenger the day it took off. And if this statement is true, then it adds further proof that NASA is faking space. Because most of us know about the air bubbles seen in astronauts' helmets in space, the harnesses and wires used to hold them up and make it look like they're in zero G, and of course, the fake moon landing missions. Whether outer space exists or not, we may never know for sure, but even if we could hypothetically and definitively prove without a doubt that NASA is faking space, it doesn't necessarily confirm that the Earth is flat. It just makes the likelihood more probable. So let's look at the seven Challenger crew members and see if we can justify the claim.
Yep, flat Earth. There was nobody aboard the Challenger. Facts, dog. Facts.
Now take a look at this picture. Here's the commander on the left, and he was born in 1939 and would have been 46 years old at the time of the disaster. And this gentleman on the left has the same name, but drop the Francis off the beginning. He's around 75 years old, which is the age the commander would have been at the time of this photo. Now look at the similarity in their appearance. Do you think they're the same person? I can see some similarities in the face, but to me, this is not conclusive proof, but...
Yes, it is. Just like Walt Disney was Hitler. Facts.
It really makes you think. The second crew member to talk about is Judith Resnick, and hers is a little bit more interesting. She was a mission specialist and veteran astronaut, and her doppelganger is a Yale law professor also named Judith Resnick. And of course, if the astronaut Resnick was alive at the time of this photograph, she'd be about the same age as the law professor. And you can see right there, there's an uncanny resemblance. Same dark curly hair, dark eyes, same eyebrow shape, same lines on both sides of the face extending up from the jaw, and even their mannerisms appear to be the same. How do you explain that? The third crew member is the pilot Michael Smith. That's a very common name. Look at the two faces. I could see this being the same person aged 30 years up.
Yep, it's all right in front of you, dog. Just gotta take the red pill and go down the rabbit hole. While getting fucked up drinking malt liquor. Only malt liquor. Ah, malt liquor. Fine malt liquor because it says it on the label. You know, yeah. Barack Obama took it up the tailpipe from Mike Obama. Just like Anderson Cooper and Don Lemon. Motherfuck you, Wolf Blitzer. And fuck CNN. Fuck the media. Malt liquor. We'll be right back. click the subscribe button for more unsolved mysteries being revealed while I'm getting totally shit-faced drinking malt liquor. Coke containers, iconic, like Old Glory, the McRib sandwich, and Donald J. Trump, greatest fucking president on the flat earth. Point on top of my game. Oh, so we're there, and oh yeah, we can't forget Fat Reggie. When Fat Reggie tried to bamboozle the people by going on eBay and purchasing those old vintage malt liquor labels, gluing them on new 40s. Just to gain friendship on the net. Completely fucking backfired. I knew 40 years fraud. We'll never forget. So we're there. The Truman Show is based on reality, dog. Reality. Facts. No WB phone. Shout out to all the truth seekers out there. Drink malt liquor only, malt liquor. Malt liquor. Views. Subscriptions. Fools.